The answer is all of these involve cryptography. And the reason for that is they all involve secrets. Let's go through each in turn. So the first is opening a door with a mechanical key. What's the secret there? Well, let's look at a key. So the secret is actually the shape of the key. Now that I've shown you this key, there's no secret anymore. If you can look at the ridges on the key, well, you know the secret. You can make a copy of the key and open whatever door this opens. Hopefully it's not something very important since I've just shown the key in a public video. And it's actually possible to do this from a fairly large distance. There was a group of students at University of California, San Diego that showed that from taking a picture several hundred feet away, you could learn enough about a key to create a replica that would open the same door. Playing poker certainly involves secrets. It wouldn't be much of a game if everyone could see everyone else's cards. Logging into your Udacity account involves entering an email and password. And I'm not going to actually type my password now, because one of the things I hope you'll start to understand from this class is, even if you don't see it because of the stars here, the fact that you can hear the audio of my keyboard would give you a pretty big clue about what my password is and the number of characters. And unlike the key that I showed you, this protects something really important, so I'm not going to expose my password. We will talk in one of the future units about how to manage passwords correctly. This involves a lot of encryption. Your password is a secret, but you also want to manage passwords and check them in a way that doesn't require storing those secrets. You don't want to store passwords in a way that could expose them easily, and we'll talk about that more in Unit 2. The final option, doing a search using google.com, is an interesting one. This actually changed about a year ago, whether or not that involves encryption. And if you try it today, you'll note when you enter google.com, what happens is you actually get redirected to https://google.com, and you can see the lock in the browser. This means it's using a protocol called TLS to encrypt all the traffic between you and Google. So both the keywords that you're typing are not exposed on the internet, as well as the search results. And we'll talk more about that in a later unit in the class. That involves both asymmetric and symmetric encryption. There's lots of interesting things about the protocol to protect web traffic that we'll talk about later in the class. So the key point is that secrets are all around us, that they're very useful for solving problems. You're using cryptology all the time, every day.